Imagine all the people cloned from my molar tooth.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula, and apologies for singing Imagine in the cold open, but today's story is about that former dead Beatle. It was reported last month by the New Musical Express that Canadian dentist Dr. Michael Zook has outlined plans to clone Beatles musician John Lennon using DNA from the dead singer's tooth and raise him as his own son. What? When did you think that was a good idea or would ever work or that people would not have a problem with it and would legally let you get away with it? You're taking elements of Dolly the Sheep, Jurassic Park, and then one of the most beloved musicians of the 20th century, mashing them all in together thinking, yeah, that's a good idea, let's raise my Beatle as a son. What? I'm confused by you, Dr. Zook, but also intrigued at your just foolhardy ambition here. He bought the tooth at an auction 2 years ago for £20,000, and while he recognizes technology doesn't necessarily exist today to let him do this, he's willing to wait. Telling Channel 4 News that the clone John Lennon could be looked at as my son. He would still be his exact duplicate, but, you know, hopefully keep him away from drugs and cigarettes, that kind of thing. He then added, but, you know, guitar lessons wouldn't hurt anyone, right? Wow, this guy is so hopefully delusional and clueless, it's actually kind of endearing. He actually thinks that this old tooth he bought is going to result in an army of singing John Lennon geniuses. We have no idea what makes a genius, musical, mathematic, scientific, or otherwise. But John Lennon, by all accounts, was a genius. And to say that just cloning his DNA is going to duplicate that process is very hopefully ambitious, and I think a bit ignorant. To Dr. Zook's credit, he did at least acknowledge that while it might not be legal for him to do so, he's willing to move to a country where such thing would be allowed. So he's pragmatic, I suppose. Such a weird story. Part of me is like, you know what? It would be cool if we could clone dead musicians and get more music out of them. I always wanted to see another album by Nirvana. And hey, what happened to Kurt Cobain? That's right, he's dead. Maybe Courtney Love could grab one of Kurt's old sweaters and bring him back to life and bada boom. What if you could do that? So many musicians died young. Harry Chapin, Janis Joplin, Jimi Hendrix, John Bonham, Brian Jones. It would be great to have some of those guys back and singing music once again. But cloning their body from a tooth you bought at an auction 30, 40 years later without the consent of the family, obviously, seemed to me like the wrong way to go about doing this. In the meantime, let's just stick to tribute bands and cover versions. And in a pinch, you can always watch that episode of Quantum Leap where Sam Beckett does his best Imagine cover. Always been a fan of that episode. But let me know what you think about cloning John Lennon using his old molar tooth in the comments down below. For now, that is The World According to Me. My name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching and listening. Until next time, I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.